A feature structure consists of properties which can be atomic or which can be complex. If you take this feature structure here, you can imagine each bracket like the node in like a node in the graph, and the outer bracket it would be like the root node of the graph. And if you go deeper and deeper into the feature structure to reach atomic properties, it's like going deeper and deeper in down into the graph. So you can say this, the great bracket, the outer bracket, it's like the root node. And maybe then you have those inner brackets. And they would be like two other nodes deeper in the graph. Then this feature structure has two properties. One property is body, and this property body points to a complex property, which is another feature structure. So in this case, I can draw it like this. Now I'm here and I can reach more properties, which are in this case atomic. Here in this case, one property is named color and the value of the property is red. Then the next one, it's shape, so I can draw it as, I need more space. This is the shape. And the value of the property is round. So in this case, it's not a complex type, but an atomic one. So I don't draw any more nodes, and just the arrow points to the property. Now here we have the producer, and the producer has a pointer, and the pointer is in front of the value of the property, and it means that at two places where we have the pointer, there must be the same value. So here we have the pointer again, so there could be the same entry, like factory here and factory there. Or because it has to be the same value anyway, here it can be dropped. Now the order in which I draw the properties in the graph don't matter, but it makes the graph easier to read if I draw the producer now below, so here below, so there won't be so many crossings in the graph. Here I draw another property, producer. And it points to factory. Now this upper complex type is done. The lower part is left. Here we have the stick. And the stick points to this node, which represents this lower inner bracket, or which represents another complex type. This is named stick. And now I don't go in order, because I would draw the arrow to producer first, so there won't be so many crossings. So I will use the same color. And now this node points to the same property as here, because there is the same pointer. If we have one color right here and one color, let's say this would also be color red, that would be coincidence, and I would draw them as two different properties as well, because they don't have a pointer. But these two have a pointer, and I represent it by drawing the arrows to the same property. And by the way, behind the pointer, there can be an atomic value or there can be a complex type. So this one here is producer as well. It's not enough space here, but it means producer as well. Then here we have again color green, which is another property as this one, no matter what the value is, because there's no pointer to the other color. And I'm close to running out of colors, but I think I can use this one. And I will draw another arrow for shape, and shape points to long. And now this is the graph that represents this feature structure.